interface, it provide a method as get init parameter, which is used to retrieve the form parameter. Servlet config interface, it is provide you method to retrieve the form parameter. So that parameter is called as, which parameter it will retrieve? Get init parameter. So this method is used to retrieve the form parameter. For retrieve the form parameter, get init parameter is used when you are using servlet config. Okay, gote hochi ame jete bele that when you are defining what like init parameter, jete ame init parameter define kariba servlet initialization parameter, to sethi bhi ame use kariba get init method. जितने आम सर्वलेट कन्फिग क्लास डिफाइन करवा से भी आम आईएनआईटी पैरामीटर रिट्राइव करवा तो लिख हेडिंग दि सर्वलेट कन्फिग दिस वन सर्वलेट कन्फिग राइट दिस इंटरफेस प्रोवाइड ए मेथड this like likho eta servlet config eta likhilo servlet config interface provides a method sir
table
ta dohulu chhi no eta dikem te hoche this provide a method get init parameter
good evening sir
good evening likho eta heading the servlet config heading the servlet config अंडर लिखो इट दिस इंटरफेस प्रोवाइड्स ए मेथड get init parameter which lets you retrieve the servlet's initialization parameters. So as a convenience the generic servlet class also implements the servlet config interface and those method delegate the calls delegate the calls to the store config object. This simplifies the servlet code by letting directly call the get init parameter. Get init parameter method. Okay. Next, we come to the point that is called as the repopulation. So, what is the work of repopulation? इसका मतलब क्या है? जब आप HTML form में कुछ data देते हो और आप submit मारते हो, तो आपका information stored हो जाता है. So, that is called as the what? Stateless protocol that we are using. इसमें से और एक चीज है रीपॉपुलेशन में. सपोज आपका फॉर्म में 100 फील्ड है, आप 100 फील्ड डाटा पास कर रहे हो फॉर्म में, और उसके अंदर सपोज आपका 2 डाटा गलत हो गया, तो आपका जो सारा 98 रिकॉर्ड्स होगा वो सब रिमूव हो जाएगा. वो मतलब जो फॉर्म आप फिलअप किए हो वो सब चला जाएगा, तो आपको फिर से दोबारा वो फॉर्म को बिगिनिंग से फिलअप करना पड़ेगा. तो रीपॉपुलेशन इज जस्ट लाइक दैट. इसमें क्या होता है ना, आपको जो फील्ड है उस फील्ड में अगर आपका एरर आएगा तो आपका इंफॉर्मेशन जो है वो रिमूव नहीं होगा, सिर्फ जिस फील्ड में एरर होगा वही फील्ड का डाटा रिमूव हो जाएगा. It is not removing all the information that is you define in the 100 field. It is only remove the data that is contain the errors. Okay. So now right, what is repopulation? it is the ability of a form to repopulate the form field with data
starting a repeat kariye
it is the ability to repopulate it is the ability to repopulate the form field with the data from the failed request. Means if any error that you found in a form, then it is not removing all the data. It is removing the data in a form where your errors are present. So that is called as the repopulation. Now, I move to the another part that is called as the servlet context. Okay.
Servlet context.
Servlet context. That is this one. Servlet context. The servlet context is a web application. It is a self-contained collection of static and dynamic resources. It is a combination of static and dynamic file. The web application deployment descriptor is used to specify the structure and services used by your web application. Servlet context object is a runtime representation of the web application. If you want to runtime represent your web application, we're using servlet context. It is a web application, is a self-contained collection of static and dynamic resources. The web application deployment descriptor, it is used to specify the structure of service used by the web application. The servlet context object, it is a runtime representation of the web application. So you have to represent your web application at runtime. Okay. Means at runtime, you have to retrieve the parameter. So see there, हम तीन तरीका यूज करके हम रन टाइम पैरामीटर को रिट्राइव कर सकते हैं. एक है हम वेब डॉट एक्सएमएल फाइल में स्टोर करके उसको रिट्राइव कर सकते हैं, और एक है सर्वलेट कॉन्फिग यूज करके रिट्राइव कर सकते हैं, और सर्वलेट कॉन्टेक्स्ट. ये तीनों टेक्नोलॉजी हम यूज करते हैं फॉर रिट्राइव द रन टाइम पैरामीटर फ्रॉम द सर्वलेट. ओके, सो नाउ गिब्सन हेडिंग सर्वलेट कॉन्टेक्स्ट, राइट. A web application is a self-contained collection of static and dynamic resources. A web application deployment descriptor is used to specify deployment descriptor is used to specify the structure and services, specify the structure and services used by the web application. A servlet context object, last point, a servlet context object is the runtime representation of of the web application. Okay, so in the servlet context, what you are using. So first, write context, scope, attribute. Context, score, attributes can be stored in the context object for storing the value. Okay, like in the servlet, as you know that ek servlet उसका इंफॉर्मेशन दूसरा सर्वलेट में ट्रांसफर नहीं करता है. तो सिमिलर वे कॉन्टेक्स्ट ऑब्जेक्ट आप जब यूज करते हो तो एक सर्वलेट का इंफॉर्मेशन दूसरा सर्वलेट में रिट्राइव करने के लिए हम यूज करेंगे यूजिंग द सेट attribute method. Attribute can be retrieved from the context object using the get attribute method. So by using of get attribute method, say by using of set attribute, you have to store the value. By using get attribute method, we retrieve the value. So you can also remove a context scope attribute using the remove attribute method. If you want to delete the information, we are using remove attribute method. The context scoped attribute the context scope is also called as it is also called as the application scope. This also called as the application scope. Okay, so now comes to that web application life cycle. So when web container is started, each web application is initialized. So when you are giving a request, jab aap request bhejte ho gmail.com, google.com, the web container is started, each web application is initialized. When the web container is shut down, each web application is destroyed. When it is shut down, it is destroyed. The servlet context listener can be used to receive this web application lifecycle event. Okay, so right. Web application lifecycle. When the web container is started, each web application is initialized. So when the web container is shut down, each web application is destroyed. Web container is shut down. Each web application is destroyed. The servlet context listener can be used The servlet context listener can be used to receive these web application lifecycle events. To receive these web application lifecycle events. Okay, this servlet context, it is a interface. When you do any kind of event, जैसे कि कोर जावा में जब आप कोई भी बटन को क्लिक करते थे वहां पर एक इवेंट जनरेट होता था, तो इवेंट लिसनर होता था जो आपका बटन क्लिक करने पर एक मैसेज छोड़ता था। ओके, तो सिमिलर वे इन द सर्वलेट कॉन्टेक्स्ट वी आर यूजिंग सर्वलेट कॉन्टेक्स्ट लिसनर। तो सर्वलेट कॉन्टेक्स्ट लिसनर में क्या है, यू हैव टू राइट द सर्वलेट कॉन्टेक्स्ट लिसनर। जस्ट अ मिनट, इंटरफेस हैज टू मेथड्स, द कॉन्टेक्स्ट इनिशियलाइज्ड द कॉन्टेक्स्ट इनिशियलाइज्ड मेथड इज इन्वॉल्वड बाय द वेब कंटेनर व्हेन द वेब एप्लीकेशन हैज स्टार्टेड ऑफ। ओके, वेब एप्लीकेशन स्टार्टेड ऑफ देन द कॉन्टेक्स्ट डिस्ट्रॉयड मेथड इज इन्वोक्ड बाय द वेब कंटेनर when the web application is being shut down. When the web application being shut down. Okay, one is context initialized, another is context destroyed. When your servlet is initialized, context initialized method is used, and when your servlet work is over and when you shut down, then context destroyed is used. Okay, so both methods include, both method include an event. It contain a event as argument. It contain the event as argument. The event object provides access to the context object using get servlet context. मिथाइल So this is all about your servlet context Okay, so in next class I will show you the practicals. So we have to go for three practical. Ame tinta practical kariba for this repopulation, servlet config, another is servlet context. So three practical we have to perform. After this, we have to move another framework. Okay, it is a one framework we have discussed. We have to go for three framework in advanced Java. One framework is servlet. Another framework, we go for servlet, struct framework. Next, we go for the JSP and TLD file. Okay, so three framework in this content we have to cover. So after the three practicals is over, then I will move to the struct MVC. Okay, and what are the practicals I have given? Do it. Only Ankita has given some kind of doing the practicals. No other person is doing that. So you have to do it and confirm me that it is over. So that in the next class, I will go for the next practicals. Okay. Repopulation. Okay. Chalo. Good night.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you.